Alright, here's another one of those stiff crash glitches. You can do it in Madman Blue also. Hang on. Hold the joystick down during the entire thing and it'll go stiff. Now keep holding it. You can do the stiff thing on any of them, but I would only suggest doing it on the first one since you're going to have to crouch in the rest of them. This is one of my favorite glitches in the entire game. Watch how it's fun. Wait for the action to start rising. There we go, it's rising. Okay. Okay, go back in here.
I wanna see this.
Hang on. Watch this. That is cool.
You're underneath it. And you're
what is underneath the acid? More bookshelves and a giant blue hole.
What's down the blue hole? Nothing.
Here's another outside boundary glitch. Sorry about that. Lewis is going to shut up now.
Mom?
Well, I've never gone here before. I believe it is possible to... Ah, I went that far back. Dang it. Here's the last major glitch I'm going to show you today. So, this is one of the best ones. This brings you down onto the Infinity Iceberg Web, and you can go anywhere that you could originally go in the iceberg lab because this place was originally meant to be in the game. But due to thrust development, they had to take it out. So, everything here is completely safe to walk all over. Occasionally including the water, which I'll show you a little bit later. And now for some proof that this was meant to be in the game. What proof? Nowhere else in the game would you find lump of fruit in the line exactly like the one in the iceberg lab. That's the only place that they meant you to go to. Okay. Alright, I'm pretty sure I can't get back up from here, so I'll just show you the water now. Looks like they didn't exactly finish with the,
sinking. Except when you jump.
So yeah, that's it. I'd like to thank you for watching this video, and I'd like to remind you that all of these glitches can be done without a Game Shark or an emulator. All of these can be done, as far as I know, on a PS2 thing. Completely normal. That's all.